Today's lab is about the separation of mixtures. We're going to learn about different techniques to separate mixtures. The first one is called chromatography. The supplies that you need for chromatography are here in front of you. So you're going to need a coffee filter. White is preferred, but I only had brown at home, so this is an at-home experiment. What the mixtures we're going to be using, or what you're going to determine is a mixture, is we have different food colorings. So you need to have red, yellow, green, and blue. Here's my green, for example, out of the box. Or if you don't have food coloring, you can always use a water-soluble pen instead. And what you're going to be determining is, with the food coloring or the pen, is it a pure substance, meaning it's only composed of one colored dye, or were there multiple dyes used to make that color? You're also going to need a ruler, and you're going to need a pair of scissors. You'll need a glass. We're going to put some water in that, and some sort of dish to put your food coloring in. The first thing you want to do is cut your coffee filter, and we want to be in a rectangular shape. So you're going to need to cut off the edges of this. So I'm just going to use a ruler to sort of make a straight edge here, and then I will use that to make an indentation, and then I'll go ahead and cut so I have a straight line here. And if you want to use a pencil and draw that, that's fine as well. You want to cut your coffee filter so the sides in this rectangular format are about 12 centimeters high. And again, these marks here where it says millimeters are the little tiny lines. The one is for 1 centimeter. So this was about close to 12 centimeters high. And then if we come across this way, it's about 11 centimeters wide. And normally, if you're in the lab, you would use your chromatography paper and you'd put 4 different colors on it and you'd stick it inside of a beaker. Well, I don't have a beaker large enough at home, so what I'm going to be using is 4 different glasses to put a piece of paper in each one. So what I'm doing now is I'm folding my chromatography paper into 4 equal quadrants. And this, as I said, if we were in a face-to-face lab, you would set this in your beaker, which are the directions in your lab manual. So we're going to go ahead and just cut the paper into the 4 equal quadrants. And each one of these pieces of paper will have a different color of food coloring on it. Okay, so I'm going to take one of my papers to set that up. And in order to set it up, what you want to do is you're going to mark from the bottom upward. You're going to go from the bottom of your paper about 2 centimeters high, and then you'll draw a line across on your paper. This is going to be where your food coloring is going to go, in the center of that pencil line. And then from the top, you want to go about 1 centimeter down. And again, you'll draw a pencil line for that. Okay, so now we're going to put our food coloring onto our coffee filter / chromatography paper. And you're going to be putting the food coloring so that it's in the center of the line that you've drawn on the bottom. When I first tried this at home, I tried to use just my food coloring and put a little dot on the paper. And what I found is it made a dot that was way too large. So what I found to combat that problem is, if we put a little drop of food coloring onto some sort of dish here, and if I take a fork and I use the corner of my fork and touch it, so I get a little bit on it, I can touch the center of my line. And now I have a much smaller dot. So that's about the appropriate size quantity of food coloring you want to use. In our lab, we use what's called a capillary tube, which is a glass tube that you touch to the food coloring so you get the right size dot. And again, I don't have that at home, so I'm improvising with the fork. The other option is, if you're going to use a pen, you can go ahead and just draw a dot, again, at your 2 centimeter line at the bottom. So you'll do this with your 4 different chromatography papers for the 4 different colors. You'll need a piece of paper for each one, and then you'll go ahead and you'll set up your chromatography apparatus. For our chromatography apparatus, you're going to need a glass, some water, a pencil, some scotch tape, and your chromatography paper. So what you're going to be doing is, your chromatography paper will be placed inside of the glass. And in order to put it inside the glass, you also want to make sure it's not touching the sides of the glass or the bottom. So I found this little trick here is to tape my chromatography paper to this pencil, and this will be holding it on top of my glass. This way, what I'll be able to do is to lower it into my glass without touching the sides of the glass or touching the bottom of the glass for the paper. So we're going to be putting water into this glass. The water must be below the 2 centimeter line or below the actual food coloring dot there. If the water is higher than the food coloring dot, it will wash the food coloring down into the water. And what we're, our purpose here is to add the water so that the water will travel up this piece of paper by capillary action. And you're gonna watch this water level until it reaches your top 1 centimeter line from the top of the paper. Once it hits there, you'll be taking it out. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some water in here. And I can just sort of, at this point, I'm just eyeballing, I'm gonna take my paper out just to make sure that it will be below my food coloring. So if you wanted to use your ruler, you could go ahead and measure that. You know, and just make it sure it's below 2 centimeters. So when you put it in, you want to carefully put this in here so that it goes straight down. If you put it at a slight diagonal, then the water will travel up in a diagonal fashion and we won't get good separation if there happens to be different dyes in this food coloring. So let me go ahead and set that in straight down. And it is touching the water. So the water will start traveling up our chromatography paper. And the idea of what we're looking for here is to see, is this food coloring one dye, a pure substance, or is it a mixture of different colored dyes that was used to make this green food coloring? So as the water travels up, the water is our solvent here, it will take the different food colorings and it will separate it into the dyes if they are a mixture. And that's the point of this lab, is for you to determine, are these food colorings mixtures or pure substances? So you'll let that run, again, until the water on your paper, you can see it getting wet, until that reaches the top pencil mark there. We are in fast motion, watching the water separate the green food coloring into the original dyes it was made from. The more soluble the dye, the faster it will be moving up the column along with the water. The chromatography paper has been in the water for about half an hour. It hasn't quite reached the pencil line, but I'm going to go ahead and take it out. So if you want to take it out early, you can go ahead and create a new pencil line by just drawing as far as your water went to the top. So I was just about there. So I'm just gonna go ahead and draw a new pencil line, which is just a little bit lower than the original one. Our green food coloring has separated into blue and yellow dyes. So we do have a mixture here with the green. You'll find out for the red, yellow, and blue what yours turns into. So what we wanna record on a report sheet is for green, the spot color are the colors that it has separated into. So we have yellow and blue. And you'll be measuring the height from the bottom where the food color was originally placed to the center of the dot. And then you also need the solvent height. The solvent is how far the water moved. So you're going to start at the original pencil line and measure the distance to the top pencil line. So I created a new one here versus my original 1 centimeter one. So to measure, we have our metric system here. We're going to measure the units in centimeters. So this one here, if we go up to the top of the height, it's between, I'd say, 8.2 and 8.3 centimeters. So I'm going to record my certain digits. So my solvent height is 8.2. It's between 8.2 and 8.3. You always want to estimate one digit further. So I'm going to estimate about 8.25, and you want to include the units, so we have centimeters. Now realize our solvent height is going to be the same for all of the different colors because the water moved the same amount. Now we want to measure our spot height. So our spot here, when we look at let's start with the yellow. The yellow's up at the top. You're going to always measure in the center of your color. So this is about the size of my yellow. I'm gonna look for the center of that and then come across here and it looks between us between maybe 7.8 and 7.9 centimeters. I want to record that. So again, you can estimate that second decimal place. I'm going to call this 7.86 centimeters. Now the blue looks like this big long streak here. So we're just going to find the center of that. And again, we're going to record from our metric unit here, ruler on the side, about where that is. So that's about 3.5. It looks like it's right on 3.5, but we want to show my ruler. You could estimate out a further digit. If it's right on the line, you'd always include a zero. 3.50 centimeters. To separate the green food coloring into the yellow dye and the blue dye, there's two different factors going on. First of all is how soluble the yellow and the blue dyes are in water, because as one is more soluble, it's going to be traveling with the water at different rates. The second is what we call the RF, or the retention factor. So the RF is what you'll be calculating here. This is how much is that yellow dye or blue dye being retained by the paper. I like to call this sometimes the stickiness factor. The yellow dye and the blue dye have different chemical structures, so how they interact with the piece of coffee filter or our chromatography paper is going to vary as well. So it's based on the solubility in the water and the retention factor. To calculate the retention factor, you're going to take the spot height, which we measured here, and divide it by the solvent height. So let's go ahead and do yellow. So for yellow, our spot height was 7.86 centimeters. We're going to divide that by the solvent height, which is 8.25 centimeters. And when we divide that out, we get a total number equal to 0.953. Centimeters divided by centimeters, those units cancel out. So our RF for yellow is 0.953.